Hello everyone, how are you doing? We are 2 minutes early, so we'll wait for some people to join in. Super excited for today's chat. I'm sure you guys must be knowing who we are talking about.
Yes, it's our favorite Ashwini Iyer Tiwari. So you guys would know about the films Nil Bate Sanata, then Panga, and Bareilly Ki Barfi.
She's been my favorite.
Yeah, those are such favorite movies. So we'll talk about our lives, our journey, and her book, her debut book, which is called Map Mapping Love. So we'll hear from her, and we are super excited to start the conversation. Let me just quickly see if she has joined, and I'll accept her invite if she has.
And it's been raining in a lot of cities now. How are you guys doing inside the houses? Anyways, pandemic made you stay inside homes, but now the rains. In Mumbai, it was pouring till yesterday.
Today it's not pouring, thankfully. So there's some relief. Okay. So what is it with this, guys? So when I am expecting somebody's invite, I get like 5 more other people's invites. So I don't know what to do. Maybe someday we'll just accept those invites and see what you guys want to tell us. Because I don't know what to do with those requests. And when I'm just accepting, I'm unable to find the person I really want to chat with. So,
hello. Hi, Ashwini. If you're watching us, please send us a request again, please. Or can you send a request?
Yes, I can send a request too.
Usually, we always on our laptops or laptop table. Today, we have spaced it out a little bit,
so we have gone far. I hope you guys can hear us, right? So if you just let us know if you can.
Yeah, say, we are able to listen to it. We are able to hear you. Say, give the thumbs up, please.
Yes, does that mean yes? I can hear why. So, yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you so much, Priya. Yeah.
Oh God, my eyesight is so bad. I mean, I have done my laser operation, but this distance is still a lot for me to read.
Well. So we'll just wait for her to join us. Send an invite. If Ashwini, if you haven't received my invite, just ping me here.
Until then, guys, tell us which one's your favorite movie amongst the three. Panga, Nil Bate Sanata, or Panga.
Or Bareilly Ki Barfi.
Bareilly Ki Barfi, I said Panga twice. but my favorite is Nil Bate Sanata.
I'm unable to join.
Okay.
Sorry, guys, I'll have to send it again.
Let me quickly check my phone. Please bear with us.
I'm sending a request to her. Panga, someone wrote Panga. Panga, I love. Sorry. I call her actually. Sorry. Oh,
hi.
I can't hear you.
Oh, I can hear you fine. Can you hear us?
I'm very new to this.
That's okay.
You just want to invite me again? I can't hear you at all.
Okay, you can just drop off. You can just end this. I'll invite you again.
Yeah.
Somebody wrote Nil Bate Sanata. Pam, Nil Bate Sanata is my favorite.
Yes, Pam. Hi. That's also our favorite. We have watched it a number of times.
Okay, I've invited her again. So hopefully there are no glitches. But what is life without glitches, guys? Tell me. I think after doing me and Tanya do so many projects together, and eventually, we just get some of the other glitch. You know,
I'll tell you what we did today. So, we figured out that we had shot a 1 hour long video, as in we invested around 2 hours in that. And we had shot a video with both of us talking to you guys. And
we
just formatted the card. And it's gone.
So, we also have the voice recording. So, thankfully, we'll be using that as a podcast for you guys. But then the video is gone.
So yeah, yes, know what is life without glitches? And with lives, all these Instagram lives and Facebook lives, we have almost not done any life without any you know, seamlessly we haven't done anything. So it's, I think it's
Ashwini is an
shagun, as you call it. And you guys have been so patient with us and, you know, bear all these
hey!
Finally, you can hear us.
I'm fine. I still can't hear you all for some reason.
Oh my God.
Can we talk loudly? Is that fine?
Yeah, maybe. Because I've increased the volume like till... Yeah. Okay.
I love the backdrop you have.
Yeah,
it's so beautiful.
You guys have not come to my office. You all have to come to my office.
Yes, we have to. Looking forward to it.
Yeah, and I created the setup. I wore your sari today.
You can see that. Always
super
a pleasure to
happy
see you.
To see you in this.
I so wish. Tell everyone that how, what was our disaster time when we were, when we did that whole talk together and it was so hot.
We should start from there. We have posted that, but then guys, it was so hot and we were trying to shoot, but we always sweating so much that we ended up not finishing the questions and hence the live.
Yeah, and I had to like, she said I'm done, and her friend also like was gave up and said I'm done now, please give me some rest.
And hence, guys, we decided that we will do this live for you guys so that, you know, the video was unfinished and we wanted to take this chat up a little longer. And here we are today. Yes. So we have done the introduction for you, but then I think you didn't need much introduction. But we will start with the rapid fire quickly so people get to know more about you personally. Yeah, little knickknacks about you, which they don't know yet. So yes, I'll start. And you have to go really, really fast, okay?
Okay.
Pressure.
Full pressure. You've colored your hair, Tanya, Sujata.
No, I didn't. It's washed out. So it's
I cut it for her.
Tanya cut it for me, yes.
Yay!
Yes, so I'll start, okay? One word that you say at least 10 times a day.
Thank you.
Okay, that's thank a sweet. That means you get so many compliments that you have to thank everyone.
No, not that. It's like, and the word and I use a lot. And in Hindi, he uses or.
You're just being technically correct, right? So, yeah. You know what? And also,
so, hello, because I so many phone calls, so I think also.
Yeah. Hello. I think hello will go for most of us. But yeah, the word which Tanya uses a lot is Shonna, Gedi. Listen now. Shonna, constantly. Shonna. Hey, Shonna. Constant. And she uses the word quickly. Let's get it done.
Yeah, because of Sujata, she wants, like, she starts and she wants to finish it.
Yeah.
And it's a task in her hand, which is good.
Everything is a task for me.
No, it's yeah, like when you were shooting, stuff. Like, okay, chalo, ho gaya na, abhi jaldi jaldi kar raha hu. Kitna time lagate ho tum log?
Yeah.
You know her well.
Yeah, you know me. What is one of your weird quirks?
Sorry, quirks?
Yes. Weird quirks.
I think the one quirk with I would have, I don't know whether it's a quirk, but it's I collect a lot of stationery. I'm a stationery hoarder, and also I maybe that's not a quirk, but that is something which just bothers me, is that everything has to be in alignment. So if a frame is slightly little teda na, then I have a problem with that. And if after eating food, if someone just leaves the plate there, I have to go and, like, you know, just wash it. And the other one thing, that's a quirk. I would say that's a quirk. And the
big
other quirk,
yes, is a quirk.
The quirk is if my children have bread pakoda and with sauce in a cup, and the sauce is just lying there, and I just get like,
which reminds me, me and Tanya hate when the color of the curd changes from white to anything else. Like people dip sabzi in curd, it turns yellow, and I'm like, oh my god, what have we done?
Okay, so you are telling a South Indian who has curd with everything. So
we have that in our house. Yes, so Siddharth does that all the time, and hence, yeah, I just go mad.
So we never by mistake also eat from the same plate. Never.
Yeah, so I have these little quirks, and I need to for me, I think the alignment is a huge thing. It's spacing, yeah. Alignment just becomes a huge thing.
I can see the book rack behind you.
Aligned.
Yeah.
Okay, now it's
bothering me that the camera is slightly tilted. I think this, you must have seen it even in the group, no? You were telling me that, I was telling you, why is this thing here? I think maybe it's just that you're so used to seeing things in a certain way that it starts dominating you.
Yeah, I think all of us, same here. I think in the video we shot, I have suddenly become blurred, and I'm like, oh my god, what has happened? You know, I just go mad looking at it. I think it's just the nature. You just keep doing things in a certain way, so you want it in that particular manner. So
yeah.
I think it's there in little bit in all of us, I believe. Yours is a lot, but mine
is a lot. Yeah. Bread and soda sauce.
Happens, and also through age and as you evolve, you want certain things in certain way, and there's nothing wrong in that.
Yeah,
absolutely. It's something about you, you know. That's you. That defines you.
Yeah.
The next one. If you could trade life with anyone for a day, who would it be and why?
You know, I really thought about this question, and it's so difficult to answer this. Maybe there are 2-3 people I would like to trade my life for one day. So maybe one would be definitely Mrs. Sudhamurthy, is because I think the kind of work she has done for so many years, especially the philanthropy work and the foundation work, Infosys Foundation work, and how the amount of books she wrote, I would like to trade my life with her for one day and see the love she gets, the respect she gets for the kind of work she does. I'd also like to trade her life for one day is because she stopped buying clothes. And she only gets saris as gifts. So I would definitely want to give her a suta sari. So so I want to know how that feels, you know. What is that control of mind where you've not purchased anything? Essential, yes, but, you know, not a single sari or anything for that matter. So that takes a lot of internalization. So yes, would love to be in her shoes at least for one day. And experience that whole aspect. I think I'm very happy the way I am, so it would be this thing. But maybe I would love to be in a very able, for example, like, you know, a CEO of a company. I would like to be in your place and see how does it how beautiful are you guys doing things, you know? Because
it's fun to exchange our lives.
Yeah, it's fun to exchange.
As budding entrepreneur, I'm learning a lot from you. Remember, Sujata, how many times I call you? I want this, you know, this thing. How do you, like, speak to HR person? Just let me know. I am very confused. What happens? How it happens? So yeah, it's a very beautiful setup, and I think to start something on your own and to develop that and to make sure that you have the focus is very important. So I would want to, I wish I had done my MBA, and I wish, you know, so I would love to be in your shoes and understand, you know, the left brain, how that functions. How do you function on that aspect?
You should come to our new office someday and stay from the morning till the evening. Then you can see, you know, what goes
around. Yeah, lovely. And you know, same here. We'll also spend some time with you and see how you run things in a massive scale.
You should do that.
Yeah. So, but I am more of a heart person. I don't think too much from my heart makes decisions more. But now, getting into a kind of entrepreneurial journey, I do feel that your mind also needs to take equal decisions and a little bit of detachment, which is very, very necessary. The attachment with everything has to go somewhere, and you need to be a little detached if you need to start something on your own, and you know, to just be also a little yes or no times.
No, I think you can always do things with your heart as well. You know, you
don't. Tanya is more hard.
Yeah, I'm more hard.
She's it more. That's like prefer. Creative people have a little more heart. Sorry, I know. Even the left brainers have a lot of heart, but yeah, what to do?
Yeah, that's there. But yeah, detachment is a very big word. I feel it's,
yeah.
It comes with a lot of evolution. It just doesn't happen over time. It's so difficult to think also to attain that stage. You know, it's so difficult. But yeah, someday when I would want to be detached and would love that. I am
already in that journey.
I am almost.
You know, I want to learn from really successful entrepreneurs and decision makers. How do they take decisions, and how do they like, you take decisions, of course, in my daily work I have to take decisions, but you know, the ability to just make it black and white and to have no emotion when you're making the decision, and making sure that you're just saying yes or no, and telling it from a perspective, I think is very important. So it takes time, is because all the time I'm just feeling how the other person will feel if I say something like this.
Yeah,
but I think I'm more
what you're saying.
Yeah, I'm more detached when I'm taking decisions, I feel.
Yeah, I keep changing between this to that, but
wow, we had gone
I'll go back to the rapid fire.
Yeah, it's a beautiful topic.
Detoured, yeah, completely with this answer of yours. It was beautiful. Okay, what is your favorite movie quote?
There are lots of nice movie quotes, but I would not say it's a movie quote, but it is from Good Will Hunting. The whole essence of Good Will Hunting says that, you know, what life tells you a lot of stories, and life gives you some lessons also. And it's important to take life lessons more. So what happens is, in Good Will Hunting, is that the janitor, he is someone who he's a very intelligent boy, and he takes life lessons from what he has read. So for him, what he has read is what he understands, but life is not that. Life is about looking into your wife's eye when she's unwell, and you know, understanding that emotion, and that emotion can never be written. So I think that's what stories do, that's what relationships do, is that it is about creating stories where it is more than just the story. It is about the relationship that you would have with every single audience or a reader in Mapping Love case, is that every audience or every reader has to take something out of that. And that's, and I won't even know most of the time. The same way, like when one woman wears your sari, for her it will be a different meaning versus someone else. So because every person's journey of opening that box and wearing that sari color, even the color or even the sari, even the texture, whatever they wear, I think it's very important to this make to have that connect, that invisible connect, that unspoken connect, which just happens.
Wow, I just got transported when you're talking. I just felt like we should keep talking constantly.
So beautiful.
Yeah,
you said, just makes so much sense. It's just stunning. Yeah,
I love that movie, Good Will Hunting. It's really nice. So there's this movie in Shah Rukh Khan's movie when he says that तुम खुल के हंस नहीं सकती तो रो नहीं सकती तो खुल खुल के हंस कैसे पाओगी. I think that's such a beautiful dialogue. You know, if you can't cry with all your heart.
लोग बड़े बड़े शहरों में ऐसे छोटी छोटी बातें तो होती रहती है.
Love it. और मैं अपनी favorite हुई
है. The whole idea of living today, I think this pandemic has taught us this whole thing of living today in the present. Not going into the past and not going into the future, and just thinking of what is happening in present. And we discussed this in length when we had met, is that it is so important to take care of yourself and your well-being and your happiness first. That doesn't make you selfish. giving self to your yourself a little time is so important, and that's what living today is. So enjoy whatever you do today. Even, you know, there were times before when I sometimes used to sleep in the afternoon, and I used to get up like at some 5-6 o'clock, and I used to feel really guilty about it. But how come I have slept for so long and I'm feeling so guilty about it? In the olden days, that never happened. Everyone had their routine, and they used to sleep for 2 hours in the afternoon, and then again the evening would go, and there were no hurry. I think as time went, and there were so many responsibilities and so many ambitions to complete, that you always were on the go, and you didn't want to sit. So nowadays, sitting is also a task. It's a sitting quietly, sitting and doing nothing is also like a guilt thing. Is that how come I'm not doing anything? I think I need to do something now. I need to
totally like relate to this, you know, because on a Sunday also, when we don't do anything in the morning, first half, the second half, I feel restless, thinking that how can I spend a day without doing anything? So I make sure that we do gardening, we clean, and you know, do something productive.
But I think doing the enjoyment to do nothing. So the movie, which is Eat, Pray, Love. I'm not sure if you've seen the movie, but she's written. Oh my God! They say that there's a phrase called dolce far niente, when you just enjoy doing nothing.
Yeah,
the art of doing nothing. I would want to do that, and I know.
But there is this whole thing called siesta time. There is this whole thing in the Greek idea of, you know, just taking a break. It's, I just got out of the name, but.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm back.
Okay. Yeah. Yes.
So
okay, we'll go to the next one.
Sorry, we just lost.
No, so you're saying something. Siesta. The siesta time was a very important aspect. Through time, we felt that how come shops are closed in the afternoon? People have gone to sleep. But yeah, that's the truth, and it's important to do that again. Okay. Yeah.
It's gone. Okay. Yeah, we can hear you fine. So yeah, even my ma used to tell me ki dopahar ko, you know, sleep for 10 minutes, it will give you some peace of mind.
Yeah.
I used to ignore her. Since childhood, she would say, no, 15 minutes ke liye so jao. And now, I think after lockdown, I've started doing it, just 10 minutes of nap without guilt. I do it. And it feels so good.
Yeah, you feel refreshed, and you know, it calms your mind a little bit, and then your productivity increases, I feel.
Yeah, but yeah, it is difficult. But someday, yeah, hopefully, I'll just get into that when I'm not guilty about spending time with myself.
Yeah, idea of not feeling guilty.
Yeah, cool. Even move on.
What is the one thing you? What is the one thing you own you wish you did not, and vice versa also.
Well, the light is going again and again. Okay.
Oh, we can see you fine.
We can see you fine. That's okay.
Okay.
We'll let you know if you.
The one thing which I own and I wish I did not. Yeah. I think I sometimes the shopping spree just gets into me, and I pick up a lot of shoes and, you know, chappals and all the stuff, and then you don't know why even you've picked up so many, is because all you're doing every day is just wearing the same chappal and going outside. So yeah, there's something which I feel that I would not. Something is wrong today with this phone, or I'm not very good at all these live events and all that.
Yes,
yeah,
so you wish you didn't have so many sandals and chappals.
Sandals and chappals and everything. And sometimes, you know, you buy some clothes impulsively, and then you not even remove the tags. And I feel, why is that also happened? Why do I need to do that? So, yeah.
I don't shop nowadays.
Yeah.
I'm so, I really, that
have
to,
yeah, I think I also have kind of, it's very difficult, but yes, I have stopped quite a bit now. I was shifting home. I was shifting home. So I actually saw that I had so much of stuff, and the whole idea of discarding, in terms of discarding in a good way, like reducing the luggage in your head and your mind. When you literally downsize the things you own, it clears. Is there any way I can solve this?
I don't know.
No.
But you're freezing in between. Sorry. I saw. Is it like a reminder that's coming?
I probably probably on your settings you have to change it. It's becoming auto lock, is it?
Auto lock.
You're not operating.
Again it's gone into auto lock. So can you hold for 1 second, please?
Yes. Please go ahead. And then till then we will just talk to everyone who is watching us now. Yes, so Sujata, what is that one thing you own you wish you did not?
Okay, so I we have this dryer which I do not use because I just feel it's not, when it heavily rains then it's okay, but then I plan it in such a way that I don't have to use the dryer. A, it is consuming electricity, and B, this makes the clothes flow hot.
Superb. Yes, okay, you're back. So I was saying,
yeah, I've been getting a lot of people actually explaining screen display. Yeah, I understand now. So basically the lock screen has to, we don't follow this all the time, so yeah.
Yeah. So I was saying something I own which I wish I didn't own is something like a dryer. I wish, as in I love sunlight drying. I wish I could just not.
Yeah, on days when I put it on, you know, out of habit because it's raining and the sun out, and she gets furious that, you know, why did you put it on? And I make sure I look outside before putting the machine on. Otherwise, I do a sun dry. So yeah, she is.
I didn't own is that the multiple amount of different kinds of shampoos I had not all discarded. I just realized using one shampoo and one conditioner. I'm not using anything beyond that. So why am I having so many? Because every time you go, then you see something, you say, okay, fine, maybe this will make your hair less frizzy. So maybe then this will be using. And then you go back to what you're using before.
But I think it's a curly girl problem.
The idea of hoarding has come from generations. Like if I go, I tell my mom, why have you kept these things? When are you going to use it? She says, no, I don't know. One day maybe I will be using it. But the truth is that you're not going to use it ever.
I think, yeah, you just see and learn. I mean, it happens automatically.
No, but I agree with the curly hair thing. I think the curly hair girls usually try a lot of things to make sure their hair just stays down. So I think that is okay. But yeah, even I have gone, now I found the perfect shampoo and conditioner. I just go for that. So yes.
Yeah.
Cool. Yeah. I'll go to the next one. Okay.
And also, I think the one thing I wish I had not known, and I'll be very truthful here, is that I picked up, I think, one branded expensive bag, and I think that's not me at all. So this so much I was not that. I didn't own that.
Yeah, I think impulse buying is something we should stop doing, and honestly, it will help us only declutter our cupboards
and not just us, but also the planet.
Yeah, so exactly. I was going to that.
I think just buying what you need and or what you really like or what you'll wear forever or pass it on to a generation, next generation. Buying those makes sense. I feel, yeah, I think all of us need to declutter. I think COVID during pandemic, a lot of people have decluttered because they spent more time in the house.
I have decluttered in all aspects, in terms of my thoughts, in terms of even when I was setting up my office. I've just kept it as simple and as mindful living as possible. So there would be only like 2 frames in the whole office. I'm not cluttered anything. Everything is just in the right place. And I think that really creates a lot of, if you believe in this whole aspect of, you know, energy which revolves around you, because I do feel that a cluttered mind is also, a cluttered place also creates a cluttered mind. And it's very important to clean up, you know, the desk should be clean. It's all in its own place. Everything has to have its right place. And you don't need anything in excess. When I go back to my grandmother's days, I think she had only like a couple of saris and she would just wear that. And even the eating things which are there at home, like there are one biscuit and there are like 10 biscuits which you're having, and you kind of tend to buy this because you have children at home and you want to always overbuy things.
Yeah.
And it all sab kharab ho jata hai by the time a month gets over, is because you're just eating that one biscuit and everything else is gone.
Yeah, I get you. I think we all have seen that phase. So many people writing so many things about you and Suta and stuff, but we'll just probably read those a little later. Somebody just said, smile, please. I think it's for you. smile again. And somebody wrote, they have stopped using microwave, which is not healthy at all. That's amazing. Yes. Cool. We'll just go ahead and we take the questions later.
My very close sister at home who cooks for us, she told me that it's very important that we start cooking in clay pots because that's how you'll get the strength. And I always asked her that how come in the village everyone is so, you know, healthy and they can, like, you know, pick up even 100 kilos of weight on their shoulders. It is all about healthy living. And she told me that it's about eating clean food, it's about eating organic food, and that in your system always makes you healthy and without any ailments. And I said, yeah, that's true. So yeah, but
yeah, I think the saying you are what you eat is also true, right? You are what you eat. I just found it funny initially, but then yeah, it's true. Actually, you tend to become that
and
clean and healthy. Yeah,
yeah.
Mind is also decluttered. Yes.
Yeah.
Can I move to this one or this one? Pretty big.
This one.
Yeah. Okay. The most played song on your playlist, and also, can you sing one line for us?
Oh God! I have lots of songs in my playlist. I also listen to a lot of chants, and that really. I had something called during the COVID time. I had a playlist called the COVID walk playlist. You know, so every time I used to go for my walk, I used to only make those songs. It could be mantras, it could be like chants, it could be across, you know, things which creates a good energy and a good vibration into your system, into your mind. I love Indian classical music. I love listening to ragas. I love listening to various classical singers. I usually go on to YouTube and hear the whole Darbar classical music expands. They're so beautiful.
Tell us a Bollywood song, like a Bollywood song.
Oh God, I'm very good singing. And I'm very good at remembering the sentences and the words. Lyricist will kill me if he gets to hear what I have.
Don't ask us for the longest time. I used to sing Ma Tujhe Salam Do. I don't know why I would sing Do. It is Ma Tujhe Salam. I used to sing Do and I used to just scream and sing. My husband told me recently, oh my God, you're singing Do. What is Do? There's no Do there. We used to go together saying that. The wrong send of song. But yeah, so we are not going to judge
you. I really like a lot of songs, but okay, let me just sing one. And please don't laugh at my singing. Okay? So, and if I falter with words, please excuse me. Gali mat dena mujhe. So, I'll sing, okay? Just one sentence I'm going to sing, okay?
Yes.
Ajeeb daasta hai ye, kaha shuru kaha khatam, ye manzile hai kaun si, na hum samajh sake na tum. Ajeeb daasta hai ye.
You sing so well.
Yeah, you sing well.
Oh my God, I don't know what I was expecting when you said.
And then left everything.
I love this song. Absolutely love this song.
Like, you know, when you're growing up, your mother wants you to learn Bharatanatyam, do your Arangetam, then learn classical music and finish the classical music. And then, like, you know, all the tick marks have to be there. But music is something which has been a part of our lives, a thing, all of our lives. Is this that somewhere you stop learning that? I tried learning in the pandemic, doing online classes, but I couldn't remember the ragas. So I've become too old. I couldn't remember. So
I goof up all the time. Yeah,
Bhumi song. I really like Damlaga Ke Haisha Ka Bhumi song. Mo Mo Ke Dage.
Oh, I love.
Yeah, I think we should just sing together. I don't remember the second line though.
Yeah.
Bhumi will kill me.
तेरी उंगलियों से जरा उलझे
उलझे कोई
लागे किस तरह
किस
रोम
रोम
बाद में पता नहीं मेरे को याद नहीं है
जो बादलों से जा उलझे We are better than you. Oh my God! Yeah.
I, you know, it's so crazy. Even in my own films, I don't remember the lyrics. I just forget the lyrics. So I have to like keep it in front of me. But yeah, it's old age also. My memory.
So, it's not old age. It is how you are. It's just that we don't feel like remembering. We just love it so much that we want to listen again and again, but still won't remember it. So I tell you, I love dancing. Okay,
yes, really
I love dancing, but I forget the steps all the time.
That's like whenever I'm on stage. Yeah. I also had joined Bharatnatyam now. A very beautiful teacher I was under, and then later on I just couldn't remember the steps. So then I left it.
Really cute you are.
Yeah, you accept everything.
Two songs. Yes, we did. I have no idea.
You're mixing two songs.
Oopsie, sorry.
Sorry.
Nothing. We'll go on to some other question where we are better at.
Yeah.
I think I'll ask you something. Answer with expressions only for the following. So you are not supposed to speak, you will just act. Okay?
Acting.
Okay. Theater.
Sorry?
Theater.
I can't hear you. What?
A theater.
Theater.
First crush. Okay. You're supposed to blush. Avocado. I don't know what like God will do. Bhoot Jolokia.
Huh?
Bhoot Jolokia.
Yeah, the tikka thing, no?
Yeah, yeah. The spiciest one.
Yeah.
Is your sister still smiling? Smile will not go. Good. Yeah. Latecomers. Correct.
I know.
Always. Yes. Like, we will just go like this. Oh my God, how can you come late? Leave. Unwashed pile of plates.
Sorry?
Unwashed pile of plates.
Yeah, which I spoke about.
With a smile. Snoring. Okay, we have to deal with it. Okay.
You have to deal with it now. It's okay, yeah.
I'll be like, oopsie. It was
Nitesh will kill me.
Tanya snores.
Nitesh will kill me now. I think I just left in the morning, I was snoring. Because I could hear my own snore and I was like, I think I was very tired. And in the morning, I could hear myself snoring.
Oh, it's beautiful. It's nice. It's a good thing. I've done.
But when you're snoring, you're snore deep, really deep sleep.
Yes. Yeah. I think in a spa once I was snoring. I figured so. I do that all the time.
She snores.
Tanya can sleep anywhere. Even in flights, she would just sleep and snore. And that's why I'm managing so well with the baby. You know, he wakes up and I feed him or pat him. He goes back to sleep. I don't stay awake. I sleep the moment he falls asleep because I can just wake up, sleep again.
So, yeah, I mean, as age increases, we all snore. So, I mean, it's fine. It's also tiredness and everything else. It's okay. But sometimes it can be like really irritating. And but we just have to pull each other's hair and then we can sleep.
Yeah. The last one, waking up early.
I like waking up early, so yeah.
No expression then. Okay, we're done with the rapid fire now.
It
was rapid, but then you did fantastic. We loved the answers. So.
Yeah,
we learned so much about you, and it was really nice to listen to all the other side, you know, sides of you and the different perspectives about life. So it was really nice.
Yes.
We'll start with some seeds.
Wait to see your son snore. It's the most beautiful visual to see. I've seen myself pouring after, like, when he's been sleeping, and it is like, wow, such a cutie.
yeah, I've seen my son snore. Yeah, it's just very cute. Very, yeah. I've recorded as well.
Yeah, it's very, very cute.
Yeah. Baby snoring. And they say, right, baby sleep, like, oh my god, you have to have a baby sleep. So yeah, they just
like wakes up on a Sunday, like 12:30, 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Like, we never tell wake them up or anything. I'm so jealous of them.
How sweet. Yeah, that's so sweet. My father used to wake me up like at 7 every, like, it was a must. Otherwise, he would be really angry with us. Yeah, I mean, I never overslept. I never slept any time beyond.
That's because my mother did that. I'm not doing that to my children right now. And I allow them to just sleep for how many hours. But yeah, I just look at them. And they'll be like, what? But sleeping, it's like, wow, so beautiful, you know.
I think we should do that. As in, assign a day and just sleep. And let them sleep and us also sleep.
Like, and switch off our phones.
And yeah, phones wake you up. I hate that sometimes. Yes, that's true. Switch it off. And but I think once a month we should do that.
Sorry? Keep the phone really far away from you. In the other room. Yeah.
No, I think once in a month we should all try that. As in, you know, experiencing that kind of a sleep and the peace that comes with it. I think... And not extending the sleep just like that. Just, you know, letting yourself wake up whenever you wake up and not with an alarm. Yeah. That'll be really blissful, I think. We should try that. We'll just start with... Because there's so many questions, but I would want to listen about your book first before jumping into any questions. So tell us about your book and also the process of it. I think writing, the process itself would be so beautiful. So just tell us how it happened and... your experience through it, or when did you start? Is it because of pandemic did you start it? So tell us about it.
No, I think writing about 3 years ago, because I had this idea and I wanted to put it on paper. It was never written to make it as a movie. It was written because I wanted to write. Also, when I write my synopsis, I always write it in too many. Words, and you know, it goes into pages. So I've always been told that when you're writing a synopsis, at least for films, just make it short, don't write it too much. So this was a great example. Okay, fine, dear, there's no one going to tell me that you don't have to write a long synopsis. I'm going to be writing the story. And I started off with 10 pages, but my only thing was that, okay, if I'm starting and I'm not going to stop, let me see where it goes. But ultimately, as time passed, because writing my novel was not a priority, I did want to write a novel sometime, but I thought maybe I would do it after I retire from making films, and writing has no age, and you can write it till your last breath. So I wanted to do that. I wanted to make writing writing novels as an after I'm done with films. But I didn't know that it will happen so early. So I hope I'm not going to stop making films. I'm going to continue making films. So that's what happened. Then I stopped is because films took over your everyday, you know, your ad films and all that things took over. And then I finished about, I had about 8-9 chapters left. And in March last year, when the pandemic started, you had two options in front of you. You saw that there's a lot happening around you. On March 28th, the lockdown happened. And I did feel that there are two options. Either we grip and cry and see the situation around us and also take it with us along. Or we look at it in a way and say that, okay.
You've lost your voice, Ashwini. Can you check if it's...
No.
Can anyone else hear Ashwini? Oh my god. I think we are reading your lips. You're asking, can you hear me? But no, we are not. I don't know why.
Guys, voice, yeah.
Yeah,
no. People are also not even...
Not anybody else.
Nope.
So everyone is saying that they are also not able to
respond. Somebody is saying they are not reading the comments. No.
What yeah, about not reading the comments? I think after talking, no, we cannot. That's such a sweet. Yeah, you can join back.
Yeah.
Yes.
You can join.
Yes, yes.
So you log out and you can join again. Yes.
Yeah, you can act really well.
I know, we understand everything you're saying. Oh, she's left.
Guys, we'll read the messages now, a couple of them.
Somebody's written a project. I think it's for Ashwini. Do you have anything handwritten in your book, in your handwriting? I still remember your college diary. Oh, I'll let Ashwini join. I'll tell Prajakta about this comment. Somebody's talking about my blouse. Thank you so much. It is not launched, but it will be launched soon. Just read. Oh, let me just send an invite to Ashwini.
Yay, I'm back.
Hi.
So Prajakta has written that, have you written anything? Because she remembers your handwriting, your college diary.
So it's Prajakta Padwal. Prajakta, which Prajakta? Hey, oh, Prajakta, hi. Yeah, I still have my diaries. I still have my books. Like I said, I'm a stationery hoarder. So I have a lot of books and I have pen colors. I have like post-its. I have everything for each story I write. I have a different book. I'm not a journal. I don't write journals. I'm not a journal writer. But yes, I do have whatever. If I like something and if I read something which I like, I note it down. Yeah.
Perfect. So you were telling about your book and please continue.
So yeah. So then when the pandemic started, so all I said was that it was important to pray for the well-being of all. It was important every day to pray for them. To pray for the frontline workers, to pray for everyone who are going through this treacherous pandemic, and then to say, okay, this is my situation, and what do I do in this situation? So every day I started writing. I started writing from 4 to 7 o'clock in the evening, doing the housework in the morning, and then 4 to 7 in the evening used to write, and then after 7 o'clock used to go for a walk, come back, have dinner, and go to sleep. So that's what I did every day. And I realized that discipline is the most important thing, is because I finished the book in December, and in January, on January 2nd, I submitted to the publisher, Rupa Publications.
Nice. I think it needs a lot of discipline. It is writing a book. I can imagine what it goes through. I'm sure you have done it before. You've been writing scripts and
Yeah, it's important to cut off, and cutting off is the most important thing, is because I realized for the first few days that every time I started writing, there were 10 other to-dos which I had in my list. So, and then I realized that, okay, whatever I want to do, let me just finish it off before I start. And then when I start writing, I go there and I start writing. And I think that was the most important thing I did, is to cut off for the 3 hours, not bothering about what is happening around me in the house. But of course, I have older children, so they are in their own world now, so that helps a lot also. And for me, my desk was my mountain, was my sea, was my everything, you know, was my hotel room, was my window. So
lovely.
Yeah,
so must be such a process.
A room by the window was exactly what I had, and that's all. I started writing every day. So you need that kind of discipline, and you need that kind of attitude that you start to finish.
What is the book about, Pat? I mean, because I have pre-ordered my book from Amazon, and I'm waiting to read. But just tell us a little bit about what is it about.
Not revealing too much.
Yeah, not revealing too much. Yeah.
For the past few days, a lot of interactions I've been having, and everyone has a very different point of view about the book. Very good reviews which are coming in, and I'm filled with gratitude, and thank you so much for that. So, this book is about it's all about mapping love itself. The word itself says a lot. So it is about love and retrieving of love and forgiveness. It is about a girl called Urja and her interaction and how she meets this boy called Anang, and the name itself was very important for me. And there's a story in that background, in the relationship with her parents, with her grandfather, and also his relationship with his family, and what conspires both of them to come together. And there's a thriller element also to it, added with philosophy. So, there's a journalist, a very beautiful journalist whose work I really like, asking me what genre do I put in this in now. So I said, I face this problem with all my films, so I think you should just face this problem with my book also now.
Yeah, it's an interesting way to put it. Yeah, you don't know which genre because you just touched upon it.
Because
everything.
I start following anyone, and I just write because I want to write a story. Now, we create new paths, we create new genres. That's what it is.
Amazing. Really looking forward to it. And
yeah.
We'll let you know our version of what we feel where it is.
Yeah, I hope you like it.
Cool. We'll move to the next question. Okay, everyone's asking the book cover is not revealing too much. And someone's asking, what's your next movie? And there are questions about...
I think we should take up these questions also because people have been really eager to talk to you, and there are a lot of questions there.
So would you answer any of...
So, my next... I'm again dwelling into something very different. I have a web series with Sony Live. It's called Fadu. It's a very, very different story written by Soumya Joshi, an amazing poet, a literature professor from Ahmedabad, and a theatre writer-director. So his story, the collaboration with him has been really amazing for the past year and a half. And it's a nice association with Sony Live also, who have been telling great stories. So it's called Fadu. Then we also have the docudrama series of Mahesh Bhupathi and Leander Pace, which will come out soon. That's also co-directing for the first time. Also producing, like I said, I'm according to the entrepreneur journey. That's also quite nice, is because you are then looking at encouraging various young minds to make their own films now. So, which is great, is because I think at every given point of time in your life span, it's important also to give back from after you follow whatever you can. So this is my time to give back, and just come very naturally.
I love how you think. Your thought process is just so beautiful. You put it across so beautifully. So just, I feel, sometimes when you talk, I forget, oh my God, we're doing a live. I have to talk.
Yeah, even talk. I felt the exact same because it's so beautiful, just the way your voice, the way you express yourself. I think next you should start narrating stories and just put your camera on and just, you know,
start talking and telling a story.
Oh God, I'm very shy. I can't do that. I didn't even know how to do this live. And half of the time that phone was going off.
Glitches are supposed to happen. I think we're just used to it. But you must. I'm sure people would love listening to you. Your voice is so beautiful. And loads of people have said, sing again. So probably we'll end it with a say song. But we'll go to our next question because we have a couple.
No,
which is
please, we'll sing a song of the lyrics we know properly.
I doubt there's a song like that. But we'll try.
We'll try. We'll plug in. Wherever you don't know, I will plug in. Where I don't know, you'll plug in. So, yeah. Are you reading the questions so that too many?
Yes, I just wanted.
You should use Google Maps for navigation. So I'm just wondering, what is that for?
Oh, probably. I think they're talking amongst each other as well.
Oh, okay. So, that was happened. Okay, sorry. I didn't know that.
So they are replying to somebody else who's asked a question. So I think that's what it is.
Okay.
Yeah. So we wanted to talk about this, that we wanted to know your take
Ronita, my really dear friend from Good Homes. She's the editor of Good Homes. She has sent me a lot of hearts.
Okay.
I love you, Ronita.
Cool. So yeah, next question.
So we just wanted to talk about your take on the portrayal of women in Indian films.
Yeah.
How has the evolution been like?
Or evolve, or whatever, change, or
yeah.
So.
And what are your favorite portrayals?
I think every form of storytelling through years change according to the dynamics of a society. and as society evolves, the storytelling evolves. So what you, we must have not seen, like, even 10 years back, or even 5 years back, is now, because we are accepting as a society, we are open to watching stories like that. So whether it is started off from Mother India, or whether it was Mr. Masala, or even it was Izajat, or it was all the kind of movies which came in, including movies like Masoom. And then, or you go to Ekta's, Ekta Ruchika's and Vidya Balan's movie, Dirty Picture. Everything evolved and your eyes changed because the society accepted that, you know, more stories needs to be told. And that happens is when the thinking pattern of a society changes. So it is important for us as storytellers to keep evolving and telling our stories and being mindful about telling our stories with respect to whatever we say. So I think that's the most important thing. There are millions of stories across the world, especially in our country, where we have stories across regional languages also, and we have many writers, many authors in across regional languages also who have multiple stories to say, whether we have Chitra Banerjee's books which are there, or whether we have the older authors. Everyone are telling good stories, and even movie makers. Sai Paranjpe came in and spoke about stories which were about a common man in a chawl kind of system in Mumbai, and that time called Bombay. And things evolved. Now we are talking about women getting empowered in certain way. The idea of pink came in is because it was, yes, was not an answer. So we evolve with time. We evolve with what we teach our kids. We evolve with what, even advertising changes according to that. Advertising changes according to psychological behavior in a certain across the world. So that's what it is. And we as storytellers have to just be more conscious, more mindful about the kind of stories we say, and make, inspire, aspire, and also entertain audiences in our own way.
Nice. And also, it's also such a, you can put it as an egg and chicken story, right? Whether the society makes a movie, you know, person make a movie in a certain way, or the movie actually changes the society as well. So it's such a beautiful relationship movies have with our daily lives. I feel it's just
of understanding how a movie can change the thinking of and human dynamics was my first movie, Nilpate Sannata, where we felt that it was a story which needed to be told, but the story was not something which people or an audience is used to seeing. But honestly, that is one story which was washed across all classes and all ages.
Yeah, and I got goosebumps seeing it.
Schools, it was showed everywhere. And I keep repeating that line that, you know, no matter who you are, where you come from, you have the right to dream. And that's what that movie talked about, that education is for all. And it told it in a very entertaining way. The same thing happened with Dangal, is because it changed the perception of how we see women in sports. Or with Panga, of how we, the most important aspect of our very being, that after you become a mother, you are forced to take certain choices, whether it is for your baby, the wellness of your baby, or whether it's for yourself. And most of the time, however educated you are, whatever, wherever you are, you need to take the choices where you take a step back. And that's why it is important to speak about going back to work after you become a mother. And it's also it is when Ariel came up with the campaign of Share the Load, there was a reason why they did that, is because it was more not just the woman's responsibility to take care of the home and the child and the responsibilities, but it was an equal responsibility which had to be shared between two people and their partners. So the idea of co-parenting came in. And therefore, Panga was told in a certain ways because it needed to be told. It was the whole idea of what Sheryl Sandberg said a long time back about lean-in. about how we need to really encourage women to come back to work after they deliver the kids is because it's both of it is equally important.
I think you answered that question. We want to talk about motherhood as well. Three of us are mothers here, right? So we want to talk about motherhood and how it has changed our life or career, or has it made us more evolved, or has it changed our perspective, the way we look at the world? I feel we all have. You answered it already, that we've become more conscious and more mindful about what we do.
Yeah, empathy just comes.
We have to be conscious about our time. We're very conscious about, and there will be one part of us which will always think about our children, and it goes without. Is because we as a gene, as a prototype, women are usually more emotional than men, and usually feel more guiltier than men. So it is important that we and I kind of diagnosed this whole thing, and I was doing a TED talk in Infosys Bangalore, and the whole idea was the yin yang and the whole if I had to decide certain situations, I've given a situation at home, and if I have to think like a man, how would I think? And if I, in certain situations, I have to think like a woman, so how would I think? So I think that is very important to do that balancing act. There was one time where my children, I think, were very young, and I had, after a long time, gone to meet my friends. We had very nice dinner, and I was a little late. I called up home and I said, you know what, I'm really late. I'm really sorry about it. And Nitesh told me that, why are you feeling bad? What happened? And I realized that I don't think so. He would really call me and tell me I'm sorry, I'm really late.
Yeah.
Those things. So, and it was kind of a realization also. It came from Nitesh only to tell me that why are you feeling bad? For what?
Wow. Yeah. True. But yeah, glad he realized and he told you. It's just a beautiful thing, and sometimes we forget about it. I think guilt comes so naturally to us, and we are so used to it. Even the entire society works like that, right? So it's an inherent thing, and we are conditioned to think in a way. But glad that it's breaking now. The norms are breaking.
And we are talking about it. And I think even...
But I think there's so many amazing young fathers now who are taking equal responsibility and share of giving birth to a child, you know. The conversation which changes from my wife is giving birth to a child to we are giving birth to a child.
Yes. Yes,
and I think
it's
that
changed, you know, it's slowly changing. It hasn't changed across.
I have known young fathers who have actually, like when they give the good news, say that I just delivered a baby girl or a baby boy. That is how things change, and that's how, like I said before, how we change in society and how mindset change in society will reflect in the kind of stories also we say.
Yeah, perfect. I think it's a perfect end to our. Live, we discussed it so beautifully, the thing,
yeah.
And our impact as a brand, how we tell stories, and as a storyteller and even a filmmaker, you're telling stories. I think we all have responsibilities, and small responsibility, but then we can change things, right? So I think it's also if you take it upon
I
you.
I think even talking about it like this, talking more about it and making it normal is really important. I'm sure a lot of people get encouraged, and you know, they tell others in the society that, you know, things are changing, and you need to educate others about these things. Like, shall we end this with a song from you?
Please,
anything. Yes, please, something. I think a lot of people have requested,
yeah.
So, yeah.
I don't...
No, break hearts.
My bad. Please.
Okay, any line from your book you would want to say?
Let's all say together.
Because it's Instagram, no, it doesn't come together. So for people,
you're talking together, so we can sing also together.
Instagram mutes one person when the other person talks, so that is something.
Yeah,
it happens. So on the camera, it looks so weird when I just put it up post. But you can tell us about your book, like one or two lines which you feel it's special, just or a bit which is very very important. You want to talk about a line or two? So that we just end it with a beautiful note.
Uh, No, I think everyone read the book. Like I said,
okay, she's not going to reveal anything, and you guys have to go and read the book to know about it all. Probably we'll just end it with a song, as you said. Can you suggest one?
Which one do we sing now again? So many.
Lag jagale. Lag jagale. Lag jagale.
Chalo. Words you will have to add, huh?
Okay, fine. We'll add it. You start.
Lag jagale ki fir ye hasi raat ho na ho shayad
is janam mein mulaqat ho na ho
lag jagale.
You have a beautiful voice.
Yes. And I'm so happy we had this, we had put this question in here. I'm sure a lot of people didn't know that you sing so well.
Someone has written, kindly sing, Dana Chubne Aayi Chidiya.
I don't know.
What is that one? Ek Chidiya, Anek Chidiya.
Dana Chubne.
Something, yeah.
I think that probably, yeah.
Yeah.
Cool. Oh my god, my cheeks hurt.
Yeah. It's always so amazing talking to you. And
yes. Wait.
So big hug to you.
Yeah, big hug. Lag jagale was, I think, for all of us, lag jagale.
Yes.
But yes, yeah. Hopefully we meet soon again, and lots. Yes, must end. Yes.
Okay, take care.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Bye. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Bye-bye.